Our session this morning is about abdominal examination. Abdominal examination. Or gastrointestinal examination, GIT examination. You know, as you know, the abdominal finding is not necessarily related to the gastrointestinal diseases. It might be a physical finding of other system involvement. So abdominal examination is very helpful in assessing patients of any disease or problem. So abdominal examination is part of examination in cardiology, proper GIT diseases, and in other diseases like tumor or something like that. So it's very important to have or to conduct a proper abdominal examination. Abdominal examination starts first of all by inspection. Second, by palpation. Three, inspection, palpation, palpation. And lastly, the auscultation. And these steps might be intermingled together, particularly the palpation and the percussion. I'm going to conduct the examination. First of all, I have to introduce myself and greet the patient. Assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu
alaikum. Ali Dr. Khan Janabi. لدي نفحص بطنك.
ها؟
نفحص بطنك ونفحص جهاز الهضم معك.
ايه.
ما عندك مانع ان شاء الله؟
لا ما كل مانع.
The exposures is very important. The abdomen should be exposed. These are the area of exposures between the external and the inguinal. Before examination of the abdomen, you should start by hand. You should start by general. Assess the patient whether conscious or not conscious. What are the causes of unconsciousness in abdominal problems or in GIT?
Mucolytic
and encephalopathy. Usually patients are doing this and conscious. So the consciousness, if it's lost, this obviously just the patient with jaundice. So when the patient is conscious, you have to start by general assessment of the patient, looking pale, jaundice, edematous, abdominal distension. These are all by general examination before starting the step of examination. And then you start by examination of the hand and looking for, first of all, for clubbing in the nail. And this is obvious clubbing. This is obvious. And this is the way of examination of a clubbing, by doing fluctuation, which is positive. Or if this patient is blind, I cannot ask him to do like that. So that's why I usually concentrate on the fluctuation examination, inspection, and doing the fluctuation. What are other causes of clubbing in the abdominal examinations? Liver cirrhosis. One. Second.
Inflammatory bowel disease.
Inflammatory bowel disease, which are ulcerative colitis, Crohn's disease.
Celiac disease.
Other.
Celiac disease.
Celiac disease. Other. Primary intestinal lymphoma. And these are the most important causes of clubbing in the abdominal diseases, right? Once you find the clubbing, you have to stage the clubbing. This is just obliteration of the angle and doming of the nail. So this is a grade 2, 1 to 2. After that, you look for the color of clubbing. If it's white, suggest what?
Hypoalbuminemia.
Usually, or spell suggests anemia, right? Sometimes you will not find the club in you on the other Kolinike. What is the meaning of Kolinike? Swelling of the nail. And this is occur in which disease? Particularly in iron deficiency disease. What are the abdominal diseases related to the iron deficiency? Bleeding anywhere in the GIT, which is chronic bleeding, lead to anemia. All right. So it's very important to examine for clubbing. And after examination of clubbing, you look for the palm, looking for the pillar, which is related to anemia, or you look for the what? Palmar erythema. Palmar erythema is a finding in which disease? Liver cirrhosis, or it is a stigmata of one of the stigmata of chronic liver disease, and can find normally in a pregnancy, and find in diabetic, vasculitic diseases, and other vasculitic disorders. So, and even in patient taking contraceptives, this palmar erythema is not specifically for liver disease, but if it's present and associated with other stigmata of chronic liver disease, it is bad. Or it is one of the stigmata of chronic liver disease. Right. The next thing in the hand examination is to do the look for the flooding. Khaliya shakir, Haji. Khaliya bakiya shakir. Bakiya. And there is a asphyxia here in the left hand, where in this patient probably suggests an early liver function decompensations. And flabbing liver, as you know, occur in hepatic failure and other failures, other organ failures. So it might be seen in the brain problems, in the narcotics, head injury, encephalopathy, renal failure, advanced renal failure, and even advanced ventricular failure. So it is, again, not specific for liver disease only. And the you in the hand, you need to inspect for tattooing, for venous line in a patient with addiction, used to inject themselves because it might be related to chronic liver disease or active hepatitis. And in this patient, this physical science is called nicotine staining. This is the typical finding in patients with heavy smoking. And it's not related to liver disease, but it is an coincidental finding in this patient. It might be related to the atherosclerotic changes, and this is an important physical finding. And then after that, you go to the head and neck, face, look for the spider nearby. Look for jaundice, fog, and this patient is blind. There is a bilateral corneal opacity with tinge jaundice, which probably related to liver disease. And you go to the neck, looking for lymphadenopathy, supraclavicular lymph nodes. What is the relation of the cervical lymphadenopathy to abdominal examination? Might be part of it might be part of lymphoma. Might be related to an metastatic malignancy from the abdomen to the supraclavicular lymph nodes. So it's very important to look for any lymph node enlargement in the neck. The examination of parotid gland, again, it's very important abdominal examination. Why? Because this is might be related to the liver cirrhosis due to the alcoholic liver, McCluick syndrome, اللي ريليتد اسوشيتد بايلاترال باروتيد سوالينج ويز ان ليفر ديزيزز ان الكوهوليك بيشنت. سو اتس فيري امبورتنت تو اكزامين بوت باروتيد right. And after that you go to the mouth, which is again important in the abdominal examination, looking for aphthetic lesion. What's the relation of the aphthous to the abdomen? Part of the inflammatory bowel diseases in the aphthous. Patient edentulous, no teeth. What does this suggest for you? Malnutrition, because he got no teeth. Look, chin is on a fall. Look for the pillar, which is not present today here. It might be related to the shukran, related to the anemia. And in the chest, you look for gynecomastia. And this is not gynecomastia, this is only breast enlargement because part of the obesity. What is the meaning of gynecomastia? Enlarged tender subalveolar swelling. Then it is on a, by definition, tender subalveolar swelling. If this finding not present, this is not an gynecomastia. There is no subalveolar swelling and there is no tenderness. ما عندك وجع هنا؟ عينات شوية. هل سمعنا دروس التوجع؟ Probably the beginning. And there is no swelling even. This is only swelling part of general obesity. And then you go to the abdomen. Abdomen, first of all, start by inspection, and the inspection should be from here and should be from the end of the patient, of the page. أخذ أنت نفس حجي to see the symmetrical movement in order to assess that there is a normal diaphragmatic movement up and down. Otherwise, if it's asymmetrical, this means that one of the leaflets of the diaphragm is not working. So you have to inspect from the end of the page and from here. And then you look for scars. Is there any scar? There is no scar. And you assess, you see that the abdomen is distended, and this is a distension which is a flank and central distension. The umbilicus was deeply inverted. Now it started to evert because of the abdominal distension. What other prominent physical finding in this patient? There is loss of the hair. Loss of the hair. What does this suggest for you? There is a liver disease, because you know liver disease associated with predominant certain hormones and on the other type of hormones. So there is no more hair distribution. And in addition, there is no spider nevi, مثل ما قلت لكم. أحسن مكان تدورون على spider nevi هي البي شيب مال النيك اللي هو not present من الهيد فور هيد and then the V-shaped هذا اللي شكل right, no spider nevi. Right, and then this is the inspection of the abdomen. Our aim is just to look for any abnormality. Now we are going to go to do on palpations, and the palpation is divided into light palpation or deep palpation. Light palpation, our aim is in the light palpation for what? To look for any tenderness, any rigidity, any bruising, or any gardening of the abdomen due to the rigidity. So before putting your hand, you have to ask the patient whether he suffered from some soreness or tenderness anywhere. بطنك توجعك في مكان ما؟
هل تلعب؟
وين توجعك في مكان؟
ما توجعك.
أنا راح أفحصك بس أدي قول لي أوجعتني. You need to do the light palpation. General abdomen starting anti-clock or with the clockwise, anti-clockwise or clockwise, and you should complete circle to survey all the abdomen. The way, either you kneel beside the patient, the bed is very high, or if the bed is very high, you can have a chair beside the patient and be very professional. And even with the chairs, I am very low for this patient. So I prepare the abdominal examination while I am standing. Right? I am going to start from here. And your heart should be flat, should be flat. Don't buckle the abdomen in this way. And your eyes in the face of the patient. Once the patient starts to show you that he is suffering, you have to stop. Now I complete the abdominal light palpation. There is no tenderness, no rigidity, no bulge, no throat, no brewery. I am going to do the deep palpation. Deep palpation for what? For the liver, for the spleen, for both kidneys, for para-aortic area, for the aortic, and for the bladder border, and for the sigmoid. These are the prominent things usually we might elicit by deep palpation, but only particularly certain, but only in the thin patient. In this patient with abdominal distension, probably we might not be able to elicit any of these physical signs. Right. I am going to palpate for the liver, starting from the right iliac fossa, and your eyes, as you say, as we say, as I say, in the face of the patient. أخذ متنفس عميق نفس عميق خش بس من أقول لك نفس عميق جدا ممتاز نفس عميق excellent نفس عميق أخذ وانطي I reached the costal margin and I couldn't elicit any border of the liver. So I have to use this way, nafas, this way only for the obese patient or the abdominal distension, right? I just hit the border of the liver, and this is the border of the liver, lower border, and you have to do percussion to decide the upper border. And now this is the span of the liver. And you measure this by the tape or by your fingers. By your fingers. هاي أنا أصابعي 7 سنتيمات ونص. فواحد هذا 7.5 وهاي 7.5. This is 15 centimeters liver span and this is accepted normal. Right? And then I will go to for spleen. The spleen you should start from the right iliac fossa in order not to miss a huge liver disease. And once you reach the umbilicus, you ask the patient, you put your hand and ask the patient to take deep breath in and out. And this is the start for the spleen. أخذ وانت نفس طويل. No. عافية. نفس. Good. I start to feel something hitting my hand. نفس. And I need to confirm it later on once I prove the ascites to by palutement. And if you're still in doubt, بس نعم ارجع على الصفحة انقلب علينا شوي هنا. ولو صعب عليك شوي زعل من قلبك. Ask the patient. كافي. نفس عميق. اخذ وانطي عافية نوب. سلام. نوب. And you have to percuss over the splenic area, اللي هي 9, 10, 11, ribs. And it is dull, probably because of splenomegaly or the extension of ascites fluid. ارجع مكانك عمو. خوش. Good, excellent. This is for the spleen. And this is for the right kidney by manual palpation. This is the This is the way of eliciting the right kidney, particularly in thin patient, pushing the kidney and waiting for the kidney, if it's alive, to hit your hand in this way. And this should be standstill, this not to be moved. And you ask the patient to breathe in and out, and you push the kidney. So I am doing it this way. Nafas ammo. Right, it's negative. And for the right kidney, this is the technique. And this is standstill. Nafas. Good. Again, it is negative. So I couldn't feel the right or the left kidney. The other palpation is for the paraaortic, which is impossible to be felt here in this distended abdomen. But the technique in this way. In this way, the technique of left paraaortic by this is for the aorta. Once you find a pulsation, you start to come to the aorta in this way, in this way, palpation from both sides until you reach pulsation, which is pushing your hands laterally. If there is aneurysmal aorta in the abdomen, if there is abdominal aneurysmal aorta, you will feel, yeah, and the aorta will be like that. So, yeah, and when you're approaching it, you will find something pushing your hand laterally. Right. This is for the aorta, for the sigmoid, this way. And for the bladder, you will come in this way. From all sides until you feel the bladder, but if it is descended, otherwise you will not feel it. Once you find a bladder, you need to confirm it by percussion in this way, and you are going to do it in the percussion side. And you feel for the inguinal lymph nodes on both sides after asking the permission of the patient. Okay, and you feel here. You feel for the femoral pulsation or brevi if it is there. And you need to examine for the hernial orifices. Go hajj go. No go. For the umbilical hernia. For the femoral hernia. Go. What is it? Right. These are all the palpations. If you have any questions, I'm going to do percussion. Percussion, I did it for the liver span. I did it for the spleen to confirm the spleen. And I will do it for the bladder. And if it is distended, you will draw it like that. You can even do it by a line. And you define the bladder domations, the bladder dome, after doing the percussion. From all sides, and you decide, particularly in patients with distended bladder and obstructive bladder, usually large prostate might cause on a bladder distension. Now this is the percussion. But this, patient have got abdominal distension. I need to confirm the presence of the fluid. First of all, by shifting dullness. And second, to quantitative by transmitting the thread. And then shifting dullness here to confirm, is there fluid or not? And the transmitted thread is to say whether it is quantitative. Because once you find an percussion positive, transmitted thread positive, it means that the ascite is more than 1 liter more. But once you find, yani, if you just elicit shifting dullness, it means it is either from 500 to 1 liter. And if it is very negative, and you are doubting the presence of ascites, you can put the patient in knee elbow position and do percussion from all sides, and you will find a cupboard like here, percussion. And this is
indicate that the fluid is about 150 cc and less. I just remind you about the presence of caput mediosa, or distension of the vessels, which is indicate portal hypertension. It's not present in this patient abdomen because, why? Because it's edematous. The only presence is the striae, white striae, which indicate on a long standing abdominal distension, not recent distension. All right. So I'm going to do for shifting dullness. The shifting dullness should be at the level, just at the level of the umbilicus. Don't do it at the side of a large organ because you will. This will be obliterated by resonant. دل انقلب حج عليه. Good. تعبناك شوية ما يخالف يعني. Good. Wait for half minute. Resonant. تابع الفلويد. Resonant. بدا يتغير. دل. Shifting dullness is positive in this patient. ارجع حجي. جيب لي عليك حجي. حجي صديقك. باش. جيب لي. هاي. That's good. Okay. مد هالرجلين. حط ايدك في الشكل. And this is the way of doing the transmitted thrill. Right? Why we are putting the hand to obliterate the muscle vibration, which might give a false positive feeling in the other hand. And you just do like that. Which is positive. This indicates what? That there is a large ascites, huge ascites. A huge ascites in this patient because, and this indicates that definitely there is more than 1 liter in this abdomen. What is the definition of the ascites? No, it is a free fluid accumulation. A bladder can be a fluid, a pregnancy can be fluid, could have fluid. It is a free fluid accumulation, or it's a free fluid collection. ولهذا احنا نسوي shifting dullness. ما نسوي shifting dullness negative في bladder distension, negative في pregnancy, negative كذا. But في ascites positive. ليش؟ لأنه free fluid collection. ينقل من مكان إلى مكان. ولهذا it is very important to do shifting dullness number one حتى تنطي التعريف الأصلي لمن؟ للأسايتس. وبعدين وراها نقيمها ايش قد هاي؟ نسوي quantitative assessment by transmitted thrill. And do you have any questions about this? Very important. من تلقي فلويد هنا عادة اكو إديمة سموها. فسو هسوي أرقام to come to it later on. Next step is the auscultation. And the aim of auscultation, what? Patient, I suspected liver diseases. I am going to auscultate number one on the liver. Yes. There is a brewery in patient with liver cirrhosis. أخاف ليكون شنو هو؟ هيباتوما. و احتمال portal brewery because of the portal hypertension. Don't forget to auscultate over the abdominal aorta. خاف يكون aneurysm. Brewy. Where auscultation over renal artery. 5 centimeter. And you auscultate over the femoral. 4 femoral brewy. And you auscultate over the abdomen. That could high abdominal distension because of the external obstruction. إلى early intestinal obstruction شو صير؟
بوربوريكمي
ولا ليت؟
ابسنس.
إلى ascites because of the peritonitis absent. It is a present. Anyway, these are the aims of auscultation. And you auscultate over any mass in the abdomen, over any swelling, over any pulsation. You have to auscultate. And at the end of the examination, don't forget to look for the edema. Which is bitting. And this is bilateral bitting leg edema. Once you find bilateral ventricular edema, you have to assess the JVV. That could have a part of heart failure, which is negative here. It's not pulsating at all. And you have to examine the basis. They could have a heart failure. We maintain a treatment, partly treated. And you have to assess the renal function. And don't forget to examine the genitalia and doing an rectal examination in this patient. Yes, because this patient got a liver cirrhosis, actimicon and the hemorrhoids, and bleeding tendency, and the scrotal swelling because of the scrotal swelling because of the edema. And if there is no small, very small testis, very small testis in this patient, liver, alcoholic liver,
testicular atrophy.
Testicular atrophy. They always say, I don't testicular atrophy, alcoholic liver disease. So it's very important to examine for the genitalia. And with the permission of the patient and the examiner, let's say we have a TGR, will the examiner, I'd like to examine the external genitalia of this patient and doing rectal examination. Well, probably you might be asking why, so you have to prepare for the answer, right? I'm going to do it by myself. And here you find there is an absence of the penis because of the edema, and there is swelling of the both testes. And this is part of the generalized edema. This means that the edema is very severe, and you need to, the patient first of all is starting to thank you when the edema gone from the scrotal area. He will feel that he is relieved, and he will say thank you that the edema is severe. So this is the abdominal examinations. Do you have any questions?
Sir,
did we forget any point?
بس ثلاث نقاط.
Yes.
يعني إحنا الجانيوكوماسي must be painful.
It should be definition. It is a tender, subarular tender swelling. Tender. جزء من الdefinition.
مرات سأقول يعني
painful. Sometimes in chronic. In a chronic, it might be not tender. In the chronic, when it become fibrosed, but in early patient, يعني أول ما يجيك patient من خليه على الدكتور يجيك دكتور أعطوك هاي توجعني يعني it is أنا painful.
سأ أوكي لما يعني حسب بالهارت فيلر إذا صار عندنا painful قاعد يكون مسيا due to الدكتور يقول shift to the ablirinone.
هي this is أنا drug that's not causing أنا not causing even gynecomastia.
ها not causing.
Not causing gynecomastia. وهاي gynecomastia by time راح يروح لل
ايه يعني ها مو شفت مو دي تو بينفول
لا لا بروبلي نوت بيكوز اوف بينفول احنا اوريدي مخليها على الدكتور
اي
بلاكت احنا ما اذا ما مخلينا اوفيلبل هذا الدرج نعطيه درج هذا ما يسوي لنا
السؤال الثاني بالشفت نيك دلنس احنا من يعني سوينا يعني رز دلنس وقلبنا المريض لازم نرجع
هو شنو معنى شفتين معناها جاهزة تروح وتجاني وراها لازم أني أسوي لها confirmation بها هاي جت حتى بعضهم يقول لك مني ترجع هم رجع لي
صار ماكلويد يقول ما نرجع يعني
لا أرجع أنا from my experience you should follow it because alright يعني something dull خي يقول had been created mass راحت
والسايت مال renal artery 5 سنتيمتر لو 2 سنتيمتر
depend on the abdomen. إلى واحد very thin, يعني just you move above the umbilicus and to the lateral, you will find it. Well, the best way, by the way, the best way to elicit the renal bruit is the renal angle, which is what is the renal angle? Is the angle between the costal margin and the spine. But this is the best way or the best area of eliciting the renal bruit.
Yes.
Any questions more?
So if during the palpation, you're feeling of the mass, not related to the liver or spleen.
Uh-huh.
Your one maneuver of it, contraction of the head,
uh-huh.
or neck, to confirm yes. this mass.
A large mass in the abdomen, you need to define this mass. Our position, size, the size of the head, tender, not tender, four relation to the organ. Internal organ or to the skin. And you need to bend your patient to see it. Is it free from the internal organs? Is it adherent to the other? And you have to decide any mass, you have to decide that it's not an hernia. you have to look for pulsations. You need to look for vascularity, feeling for the brewery, auscultation over this mass, and the, it's very important.
So another, during the palpation of the spleen,
from
the right iliac fossa to the toward the spleen,
to the area of spleen,
to the spleen. Another one who to the shift the patient to the left side and palpate it. If not, palpation during this maneuver.
أنت من تسوي palpation for the spleen ولقيت the spleen أنت ما معذور عن تقول مالك عذر إلى قلت ماكو spleen. أنت you have to look the spleen in other ways. فأنت لازم you try to bring the patient to the right side, you feel the lower margin. You have to percuss the spleen.
So another maneuver, you catch the lower costal margin.
Yes, there is. There are so many maneuvers for the organomegaly. Mm-hmm. The organomegaly, خصوصاً بالثين بيبل تزم الكوستر مارجن كل نفس يجيك سبيل يضرب إيده. فهذا another way. Another way is the scratching methods. طين اسمها مالتك. اللي هاي ما لكم تستعملوها بس أنا مثلاً هسه أنا مثلاً شكيت بأن الليبر واصل لي هنا. خلينا نقول هذا هنا الليبر. But you put your stethoscope and you start to scratch. Once you approach the border, you will hear it very يعني clear under your stethoscope اللي هو هسه ما قاعد يسمع لحد الان. فمعناها there is no organomegaly. وهاي you can apply it with any mass. Any mass خلينا نقول mass central. من تجي للسماع يعني للبوردر مال هاي الماس راح it will be transmitted to the your stethoscope.
Transmission
more strong is there.
Transmission
is solid.
Yes.
يعني conduction. In this way. Any question? So I think our session for the abdominal examination for today is finished. And we are going to do special sessions for the special cases. Special session for special cases. In all the system, in the respiratory, in the cardiovascular, in the abdominal GIT. And we are going to go specifically for this. يعني for example how to examine patient with joints, how to examine patient with malabsorption, how to examine patient with severe asthma, how to examine patient with hypertension, how to examine patient with infective endocarditis. We are going to tackle all these special cases. Okay?
Yes. Thank you. Thank you, sir.